The human brain, quite a demanding organ, and of course a very important organ, because all those decisions that we make throughout our life and everything else that goes with it is influenced by the brain. Energy levels, our ability to think, our ability to bring a quietness to the mind, our ability to convey and interpret reality, and more. Now, what does the brain rely on? Oxygen is very, very important. And oxygen is carried in the blood. So blood flow is very, very important. Is there a way to breathe to optimize that or even to increase it? And it may not be the way that you think. So when we think about breathing, we're thinking about the speed and depth at which we breathe. So say, for example, here we have time, and we'll say here we have volume. And we're talking about depth. We're talking about how much air you're taking into your body during one breath. If you want to improve blood flow to the brain, breathe less air. How do you breathe less air? Well, bearing in mind that you only have two parameters here, you have speed, you have depth. And if you want to breathe less air, breathe a little bit slower and breathe lighter. And when you do that, you're going to increase carbon dioxide in your lungs and blood. How do you know? Well, you're going to feel a sensation of air hunger. And carbon dioxide isn't just a waste gas that everybody talks about. It is true, we produce it internally. So it's a byproduct of our metabolism. And in the blood that's coming back to the heart and back to the lungs, we breathe out excess CO2, but that's the key, excess. We only breathe out about 15% of our carbon dioxide. We hold on to 85%. When we breathe a little bit less air, by reducing the respiratory rate and reducing tidal volume, this in turn causes us to reduce minute ventilation. Now we're breathing less air per minute. As a result, carbon dioxide increases in the lungs. And because carbon dioxide increases a little in the lungs, it will also increase in the blood, leaving the lungs. And carbon dioxide is a natural vasodilator. Now, normal carbon dioxide is about 40 millimeters of mercury pressure. You don't have to be too worried about that. But every 1 millimeter increase of CO2 can improve blood flow to the brain by about 2 to 3%. If you breathe a little bit less air, as in the exercise from Oxygen Advantage called Breathe Light, you would expect to increase carbon dioxide in your lungs and blood by about 2 to 3 millimeters of mercury. So if carbon dioxide increases in your lungs, and if you're doing this for about a minute or so, you start increasing carbon dioxide in the blood. And if you're increasing carbon dioxide in the blood by about 2 to 3 millimeters of mercury, and bearing in mind that every 1 millimeter increase of CO2 will improve blood flow to the brain by 2 to 3%, you can improve blood flow to your brain by, we're talking about 4 to 6%, simply by breathing less air. Now, that's just sitting down. You can even practice it there. Take a soft breath in through your nose and a really relaxed and a slow, gentle breath out. Soften your breathing to the point that you feel air hunger. And even though, yes, you're taking in less air, you will feel that you're not getting enough air. But that doesn't mean that there's reduced blood flow and oxygen delivery. Your brain is now receiving increased blood flow and increased oxygen delivery. And that's very important for the 80 billion brain cells that are in the brain. They need plenty of blood flow and plenty of oxygen. So it's under your control.